morning, Tamina Khan is here. NTK Maths is fun. In today's video, we will see the checklist for A-level Mathematics P1. The code is 9709. When we go for any paper, we are preparing for any exam, we have to ensure that we have revised all the concepts, we have ready for all the concepts or not. So this checklist will help you to know that you are fully ready for your exam or not, or if any concept is left, you can revise it. So before I begin, you can see in the bottom my website address and my blog address. You may find many free videos which will help you to revise or recap any concept. So let's begin with the checklist. According to the CIE syllabus, these are the 8 topics. And one thing I would like to say, I will not explain any concept here. For the explanation of the concept, you can refer my videos, or I am also putting revision guidelines which are in preparation, few are done. So I'm uploading them on the website address, tkmaths.com. So you can refer those revision guidelines, which are incomplete, will be completed within this month. So, and like I said, ntkmaths.blogspot.com, this blog site has free videos. It is user friendly, so you can refer it. And I will go a little fast over all these things. The pointers are here. You can put the video on pause and note down. At the end of these topics, I have selected few past paper questions. And I have selected in a manner, if you will revise those 5-6 questions, you will be able to revise the whole concept of the topic. When a student prepare or revise 2 or 3 year past paper question, he may come across with the same type of question. He may not go through different types of concepts which are required to understand in a topic. So here I'm facilitating in a manner, only those 5-6 questions will help you to recap the whole concept. So quadratic may you need to know completing a square, how to change any quadratic equation given in this form into completing a square form, and how to sketch with the help of that, and then apply discriminant on this quadratic equation, and how discriminant helps you to find out roots. So another important point when you're reading these, I'm not reading in detail, I'm not explaining in detail. When you're reading it, you should be able to make connection in your mind. You should be able to immediately relate, okay, so it is that type of question I have done. But at any point, if you feel like, okay, what is this? You know, sometimes you said, okay, I can't recall I have done anything of that type. I cannot make any connection. In that case, you have to refer your book, or you have to refer any YouTube video or the videos I have given on my blog site or website. So it will help you to revise your concepts, right? So this is the important thing of checklist. Quadratic and functions are most of the time merged, these two concepts, right? So the questions I've selected will definitely help you to revise the concepts. So understanding of the terms, what is range, in this form questions are given, composite function you should be able to find out, g of f, f of g, and what is one-to-one function, what is the meaning of 2 to 1, 1 to 2, what do they mean, and inverse function, and graphically how do you illustrate them, how do you make sketches. And another thing which has been introduced into your syllabus this year, last year rather, but exam did not happen, and that was transformation of the graphs, right? These type. So what is the meaning of all of these type? You need to understand, because if simple graph is given, how you will transform into these forms, whatever is given to you. And in terms of reflection and stretch, what does it mean? So all these things you should be able to reconnect, right? And again, if you are not ready for this, for example, right, and you need any help and you can't find any relevant video, I'm trying to put videos because it is in process. You are uploaded, if you are not, I make videos at the request of the student basically. If you have any particular requirement and you want me to help you out, you can put in any of maths video in the comment box that if I can help you in that, so I can upload a video on that because I get the indication immediately. And you can also subscribe and like my channel, my one of the videos, so that you get intimation immediately, because this month I will upload many P1 videos also, which are in pipeline. So coordinate geometry, this is all what you have done mostly in maths also, but the way it is asked here is a little challenging. Another important addition in this is the equation of circle, basically. So question related to those you should be able to answer. The lines and circle is also introduced. So those questions, you will not find it in many past paper question. I will prepare a worklist checklist, sorry, video for explanation with examples, so you can refer that also. Now, circular measure, make sure when you are attempting a question of this topic, you have to change the mode of the calculator. It should be in radian mode, right? Which is a common mistake students usually make. And when you are revising circular measure, it seems very easy because there are only two or three formulae in it. But you need to know all the properties of the polygons, because any polygon can be included into it. Most of the quadrangles and quadrilaterals, triangle. So those type properties you should know. In trigonometry, again, it is solving equation. It is identity. It is a sketch. And I have given few examples here. Of course, I've taken it according to your syllabus. So you need to understand how to do this, right? So the type is given here, identities are given, and degree and radian specifically I've mentioned here. Be very careful about it. Now in series, it is binomial series, arithmetic, geometric progression. So all these pointers, go through it and you understand what is the meaning, convergent, divergent, geometric progression, what does it mean? You need to be able to reconnect. I'm repeating, it is extremely important that you should be able to understand what we are talking about here. If you're going for exam, it means you are ready for that, for it. So you should be able to make connections. So notations you should be able to understand, and at your level, it is only polynomial functions, not trigonometric or exponential or logarithm for differentiation. It's only polynomial. So you, with reference to that, you should be able to understand all this. And in connection with the sketches also, very, very good questions have been asked. If you have a clear concept of this. So in integration, the basic thing that is, it is a reverse process, why it is called a reverse process. And then these are the concepts in integration. Area of region bounded by a curve, between a curve and a line, between two curves, volume of revolution about one of the axes, and what is volume of revolution. Now let's come to the past paper questions. Now, important thing here, I have not just put the questions here, rather I have put in front of it few lines about what is asked in that question. So that if one is actually interested, for example, about tangents, he can practice this question and this question. If somebody is interested about some, you know, it seems like what, find unknown for the given situation. So there is some unknown value given in the line and you have to find it out with the help of the situation of the line and curve given to you. So these type of hints I have tried to give you. So whatever question you want to practice, you can, but I have tried not to select so many questions. The reason is considering that you have already revised, but now you have little time and you want to recap everything. So what you should do, which help you to recap all the concepts. Increasing, decreasing function is very important. You should have a very good idea of it. It has been asked in multiple ways. Coordinate geometry, it's more or less same those who have done in maths. Maths is compulsory for all. Little extra, but usually it is same. So it's a good recap. And in circular measure and trigonometry, you can see here, diagram is given to you, shaded area. Sometimes diagram is not given to you. Only description is given to you. So I would recommend always make a rough sketch immediately. It really helps you. Trigonometry, if you want to, mostly in trigonometry, they ask you to prove identity and write after that solving equation. right? Like here I'm saying solve trigonometric equation in radian, find range and basic question. So it's a basic question. If you want to go for easy one, you can attempt it. And sketches, range, values of inverse functions, so many concepts are involved. You see inverse function. So here you will see the concept of function and inverse function is involved or mixed with the trigonometry. So in series, binomial, I have given you 3-4 binomial type of questions. And then in AP GP scenario is given for AP, find unknown value in GP. So in many questions, AP and GP are merged, are mixed. Part of it is AP and then it is connected with GP or vice versa. So all these questions will help you to come to practice those type of concepts, right? An application of GP. Now it is a word problem. Okay, how GP is applied in word problem. So it's not a straight question. So it's a good question. You do practice it. Then it is differentiation and integration. You can see here, sometimes figure given, sometimes not. And you know, I have written questions of integration usually have a part where differentiation is applied. So these two concepts are also merged multiple times. So that's why it is said, given you are not, you have not studied both the type, try not to practice part paper question because you get demotivated otherwise. Anyway, thank you very much for watching this video. And if you have learned something, you have liked it, please share it with your friends. Press like and subscribe button. And before this October-November exam, I will definitely put up many interesting, challenging question, I would say rather. For me, it is interesting for students. At times, it is challenging. So I will try to put the explanation of all those as much as possible. So you will get the indication. Thank you very much. Once again, take care. Allah Hafiz.